First of all, let me thank you for converging right here. And two, I want to thank Kenyans for the manner in which they participated yesterday willingly in elections. And of course, I want to support those who voted for me, those who believed in me, those who share the same dream of a better country. I want to thank my running mate, Ronnie, for the support which he gave me throughout the campaign, my campaign team, which worked tirelessly, worked odd hours, and managed to ensure that we toured virtually in about 44 counties of the entire 47 counties. I was happy that wherever I went in the entire counties, there was warm reception, and we were accorded deep respect by Kenyans of all walks of life. I want to take this opportunity also to say that I am very willing to stand by the will of the Kenyan people, because democracy is about the will of the people. And I am more than willing to stand by the will of the people. I want to appeal to IEBC. And precisely because of the statements that they've issued in the course of the day, that the ground rules were that the presidential contest would have the results first. We are now getting governor's results. We are now getting senator's results, women rep results, and MP's results when the full count of the presidential contest is not out. My understanding was that that would be the first one out so that the country can get out of the anxiety mood that we are getting into. I also want to remind IEBC that 5 years ago, the sad events that took place culminated into the systems of IEBC not working. And it is strange that the returning officer for the diaspora was able to return the results today by 1 o'clock, and we don't have those results. Yet we have not gotten any results from the 290 returning officers in the 290 constituencies. We are getting real-time results, but we are also getting results from agents, which differ, in our case, a little. It might not have a major impact, but they do differ a little. So I want to appeal to IEBC, and I said this yesterday after I voted, that it was very important for them to ensure that they instill confidence in our electoral process. We appreciate what they are doing, but we are now told that they've gone back to the manual system. Yet we know that they invested heavily in a computerized system. We need to save the country out of anxiety, although the ground rules allow it for 7 days. But since they have released the provisional results, it is more than important that they go the whole hog and clear fast with the presidential results so that Kenyans can have the benefit of the president that they have elected. I and Ronnie are more than willing, and we wish whoever is elected as the president of Kenya all the best. And of course, there is lots of work to be done in terms of nation building that we all ought to get together in. But we are more than willing, once the results are announced, to support whoever is elected as the president of our great Republic of Kenya. God bless Kenya. God bless all of us. Thank you.
Any questions?
Yes.
Maybe as you get your question, let me try and speak in Kiswahili. Ningependa kuchukua fursa hii kuwashukuru wa Kenya wote kwa vile walijitokeza jana kupiga kura. Na kwa mapenzi mengi zaidi, ningependa kushukuru pia mgombea mwenza wangu, kwa vile tulivyotembea, tulitembea katika kaunti 44 kutoka kwa zile kaunti 47, na Wakenya walitupokea kwa njia safi zaidi. Pia ningependa kupongeza timu yangu ambayo ilikuwa inapanga mikakati ya campaign, na pia kuwarudishia shukrani familia zetu kwa vile walitupa nafasi ya kutokuwa nyumbani na kutembea kule nje kutafuta kura. Mimi ningependa pia kuwajulisha Wakenya ya kwamba mimi nitasimama imara na matokeo ambayo yatatolewa. Na kwa hivyo nahimiza IEBC, makubaliano yalikuwa ya kwamba matokeo ya urais ndio itakuwa ya kwanza. Kwa sasa tumeanza kupokea matokeo ya magavana, ya maseneta, ya wabunge na pia ya kina mama. Na tungependa kuwa na nchi ambayo haifikirii zaidi, haiwekwi kwa tashwishi. Tunaambiwa kila wakati ya kwamba mitambo ina shida, na kwa hivyo wamerudi kwa ile mambo ya mikono, yani manual. Penda tu kuwahimiza watie bidii, wamalize na mambo ya uchaguzi wa urais, ili Wakenya waweze kujua ni nani rais wao. Mimi na Roni tuko tayari. Tuko tayari katika ile jambo ya kujenga taifa, katika kuunga mkono yule ambaye atateuliwa kuwa rais wa Jamhuri ya Kenya. Kenya iko na shida mingi, na tungependa kumuunga yeyote ambaye atachaguliwa mkono ili tujenge taifa letu. Asanteni. Now you can shoot your question.
I have two questions, sir.
Two?
My first question is...
And you are?
I'm Charles Chandler from
B4. Okay.
And we said about
that. I want to appeal for CAM, and IEBC has let us down, because they should have started by counting and concluding with the presidential ballot first. At the moment, it's at 40%. And even that is real time. No returning officer has brought the forms that are required so that we can have the results. And even the only returning officer who has brought, that is the one for diaspora, they have not released those results. It is that anxiety that I want to appeal to Kenyans to keep calm. It is not possible to say much on your first question, because we need to get the results out first. Then officially I have also said, we are willing, we are going to respect the will of Kenyans. And that is what we want to do once we know what the results are. Thank you. Yes?
I don't know if I had you right.
The differences, as I said, are not many. But you find that the results you get from your agents and what has been released on the provisional list differ. And that's why it is important for the returning officers to bring back the returns. We do at our level, the differences might not be that much, but we don't want anything that can create anxiety to our country. That's why we thought it was nice to address this conference, press conference, so that we can appeal for CAM, but also appeal to IEBC, not to let us get back to where we were 5 years ago, where all of you understand what we are speaking about. It is important for the returning officers to return those forms, because we are depending on provisional results, which we are told are real time. Now we've been told the systems are down. We are now going manual. And I think that's not a good thing for confidence building of an institution of IEBC's nature. I want to encourage them, but I also want us to get it right. Sawa? Yes, please. Well, life must go on. As I've often said, on the 5th of March, which is today, Kenya must go on. And there are very many areas we can build the nation. It doesn't just have to be in politics. There are very many other areas in which one can build the nation. Some of us have had distinguished careers, whether in football, whether in the insurance world, whether as the longest serving assistant minister in the Kibaki regime, we've had distinguished careers. And therefore, we are there to serve the nation. It's a country we love. It's a country we'd like to see out of the out of the woods. And therefore, we want to wish everybody well and wish the country well. The next leader, no doubt, has an enormous task and challenges in front of him or her in terms of nation building. And this is collective responsibility. Thank you. Yes. I think the important point is that we've never had that high percentage of rejected votes. You recall I was the first to make an official complaint to IEBC that there was not enough civic education. I think it is important for IEBC to do a national audit, because that could do or break, especially for those who might consider that they got aggrieved by the loss of those votes. But also more important that a third is coming from one county, a third of the rejected votes, does display that there is a problem somewhere. And the earlier we look at it, the better. What we don't want to have is a country of suspicious characters creating suspicious stories. So we need to have everything in a transparent and accountable manner. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.